Hello everyone, this is Jan Chromy and together we will continue the course Interdisciplinary Approaches to Language and its Use. This will be the last presentation on language comprehension. We will focus on the measures used in eye tracking experiments which target reading. This is a made-up example of a scan path representation of a process of reading of the sentence Martin avoided Thomas all the time because he was very reclusive. The dots represent fixations and the numbers their length in milliseconds. The vertical bars delimit the analyzed regions in the sentence. We can see that the imaginary reader did not perform only the forward saccades, but she also regressed during reading. From the region he was, she first moved back to the region Thomas, and then even to the beginning to the region Martin. Then she made a long forward saccade to the end of the sentence. The question is, how should we analyze this, especially if you would have 40 participants in the experiment and we would like to get overall results. A very frequent measure is the first fixation duration. This is the duration of the first fixation of a word or in a given region. Any further fixation does not matter. In the case of the example sentence, the first fixation duration in the region all the time is 244 milliseconds. Similarly, the first fixation duration in the region Thomas is 250 milliseconds. This measure is important because it captures the difficulty of the initial processing of the word or region. Another measure is called gaze duration or first pass reading time. The first term is used more often in case we focus on words, the second in case we focus on longer regions. It is defined as a sum of all fixations in a region until the reader leaves the region either to the right or to the left. In the example below, first pass reading time of the region all the time would be 443 milliseconds, which is a sum of 244 and 199 milliseconds. You may see that it can be quite similar to the first fixation duration. In fact, the only region where first fixation duration and first pass reading time differs in this example is the region all the time. For regions Martin avoided Thomas because he was very and reclusive, these measures are identical. Therefore, this measure is typically more informative in case of longer regions, for example in discourse analysis. Another measure is the total fixation time. This is simply the sum of all fixations in an area, including rereading. In the example below, the total fixation time for the region Martin is 508 milliseconds, which is a sum of 232 and 276 milliseconds. This is an often used measure. It may be interesting, especially in case there are no effects for first fixation duration or first pass duration. In that case, it informs us that there is a difficulty in the later stages of processing. Another measure is rereading time. This is the sum of all fixations in the region after it was first left. In other words, we can get the rereading time if we subtract gaze duration or first pass reading time from the total reading time. In the example below, the rereading time for the region Martin is 276 milliseconds. This is a measure of the later processing difficulty. An important measure is the regression path duration or go past time. It is defined as a sum of all fixations in a region from the first entering the region until moving to the right of the region. This means that we add up not only the fixations in the given region, but also all fixations which are done after a regression prior to getting to the following region. In the example below, the regression path duration of the region he was is 851 milliseconds. Regression path duration is important because it is independent from other measures. It is the time needed to process the region before going further. For example, it is very informative in experiments targeting ambiguity solution. There are also other measures which are less used but may be useful for specific research purposes. These are first fixation probability, which is an overall probability that the region was fixated throughout an experiment. Another measure is the first pass regression out probability. This is the probability that a regression was made from the region throughout the experiment. The last thing we need to mention is the so-called spillover effect, which causes serious methodological problems in eye tracking research. It is clear that processing of a word is not restricted to the fixation time of a given word. We process previous information even when reading following words. The spillover effect may be easily demonstrated. The fixation times of a word when it is preceded by a low-frequency word are longer than when it is preceded by a high-frequency word. Before we will conclude this presentation, I have two reading tips for you. If you would like to find out more about the eye tracking measures, you might read a comprehensive paper Eye Movements and Measures of Reading Time by Simon Liversedge, Kevin Patterson and Martin Pickering. Also, I would like to recommend you an interesting study which offers a way how to analyze scan paths by Titus von der Malsburg and Shravan Vasisht. If you enjoy the presentations, we would be glad if you would like them on YouTube. That is all from me now. See you next time.